very much. Nice to meet you. I'd ask you that. I'm asking you, is it from justice?
Don't be very proud as you.
I'm not saying I'm proud.
Okay.
I'm
okay.
Asking you.
Don't
cut
yourself. Okay.
Ask the question.
Anyway, sorry. Take care. The ambulance is there.
You want to talk? You want to talk?
No, that's it. I'm asking you. Don't ask my question.
That's justice.
Anyway, I'm preaching. Thank you very much.
Tell him.
Khalas, from bed to worst. From bed to worst. Khalas. So my point here is, he misunderstood anyway. He proved my point. They don't implement the Sharia, that's why. There's no justice. Because it's the Sharia tells you to give justice. Umar ibn al-Khattab, and Warda, in a time when there was a drought, he said to his belly, start making noise. I'm not going to feed you nothing until I feed the people. He was the leader, you know? Umar ibn al-Khattab, when he had the woman, she said, where is the leader of the believers? That my children have no food. He said, what? He said, wait, he went and he got the food. He was carrying the food in his bag. And his servant, he said, let me do it. He said, no. I'm going to be responsible for her. And he carried out, he put it, he made it for her food. You see what I'm saying? That's why the people knows that Islam teaches you, look, is it from justice to kick out your mother and put her in all people's houses? You know what I mean? Is it from justice to kick out your daughter till you're 16? Get out, get your own life. See what I'm saying? So no, please.
That's
so,
what happened.
Sir, no. That, is it from Sharia?
That happened.
Human does it.
It's
but is it from the law? Is it from the? Is it from justice to teach your children that if your father tried to correct you, call 999?
Listen to me.
Islam teaches you what? Look after your mother. Even if she's rude to you, of course. Islam teaches you don't harm your children. But if your mother get angry with you, be good to her. Remember, because of how you're alive, that's what Islam teaches you. If you ask them a question, I'll tell you.
I'm teaching here. Yes, one question.
I don't want to answer.
One question.
I'm free.
One question.
I'll answer.
Yes,
so Islam teaches you what? Because I ask you a question, you answer it. I ask him a simple question. Is it from justice to separate?
Is it from justice? What you say now, in this country, or America, or France,
I'm not asking
what happening there.
And I'm asking. I'm not talking about that. You can see, sir.
It's not happening.
That's not the law.
It's not happening.
It's not the law.
It's not happening.
Brother, do you differentiate
between? There is no law.
Is it?
There is no law.
That's a problem. You know what some others understand? And they start talking, it's a problem.
There is no law. Don't talk about law. There is no law there.
It's law. It's not law.
It's law. I don't know what to do. Maybe the sun is too much hitting me. One guy drove me crazy over there. Brother,
he's driving an animal mad as well.
See, I can't lie. My brother, please.
How do you have the energy to do this in the heat?
Yeah, leave me alone. I'm preaching. My point here is, look, Islam teaches you, even if your parents try to be rude to you, take care of your parents, take care of your mother. Islam doesn't teach you to call 99. You know what I mean? Of course, it's not allowed to harm your children. But Muhammad said, don't harm, you know? So that's what I'm saying. I asked him a simple question. Is it from justice to separate the mother from her baby and you send the mother back to her country and you take the baby? He's not answering it. Why? Because he knows which country is doing that. It's not a Muslim country. Is it from justice to go destroy countries based upon false information while you know that? America, Bush and Blair went to Iraq, destroyed countries based upon a false information. When they do enough for Iraq, rather than sending back the Iraqis to the country, they should have no problem for the Iraqis to come to Britain and to America because they destroyed it.
Alhamdulillah.
Took out justice. You man from the, as I said back home, Malhima Rabiyara. And you're a Mkhalouk, Khalouk. Khalouk, Khalouk. Jahannam Khalouk, excuse me. Khalouk, Europa. Alhamdulillah, Shaykh.
You pretend as Muslim.
Huh?
You pretend as good Muslim.
But I'm not saying
Muslim. You pretend as good Muslim, but you are not.
I'm not saying good Muslim.
You pretend it as that.
You pretend it.
Where did he say that?
Listen to me. I'm not talking to you.
But I'm not talking to you. I never pretend to be good Muslim.
I'm not talking to you.
Look at you, sir.
Who's telling you?
Generally speaking, we know what is good, what is bad. But you need what? The Creator. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran. Allah ya'lamu man khalaqa wa huwa al-latif al-khabir. Does he not know who creates? the more generous, the well acquainted with his creation. You see, Allah سبحانه وتعالى أبى حكم الجاهلية يبغون ومن أحسن من الله حكم لقوم يؤمنون. نعم, so as a Muslim we say, worship God according to His law. Don't worship God according to your desires. You know, because everyone has a desire here. But when you worship God according to His law, that is what objective. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophets and messengers to teach us how to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I will stop here. Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbi. Wallahi, inshallah, barakallahu feekum. If there's any correction or question, you can. As I've said many times, I'm just human being like you brothers. So, you know, I can make mistakes.